Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Jasmine. I'm from local Ewan. I share my material about area language and function. What brain regions control our language and how do we know this? The brain is key to our existence, but there's a long way to go before neuroscience can truly capture its triggering capacity. For now, our brain control series explores what we do know about the brains. Command of 6 central functions: language, mood, memory, vision, personality, and motor skill, and what happens when things go wrong. When you read something, you first need to detect the words and then to interpret them by determining context and meaning. This complex process involves many brain regions. Detecting text usually involves the optic nerve and other nerve bundles delivering signals from the eyes to the visual cortex at the back of the brain. If you are reading in Braille, you use the sensory cortex towards the top of the brain. If you listen to someone else reading, then you use the auditory cortex not far from your ears. A system of regions towards the back and middle of your brain help to interpret the text. Thus include the anterogyrus in the parietal lobe, recognition area, comprising mainly the top rear portion of the temporal lobe, insular cortex, basal ganglia, and cerebellum. The regions work together as a network to process words and word sequence to determine context and meaning. This enables our receptive language abilities, which means the ability to understand language. Complementary to this is expressive language, which is the ability to produce language. To speak sensibly, you must think of words to convey an idea or message, formulate them into a sentence according to grammatical rules, and then use your lungs, vocal cords, and mouth to create sound regions in your frontal, temporal, and parietal lobes. Formulate what you want to say, and the motor cortex in your frontal lobe enables you to speak the words. Most of the language-related brain activity is likely occurring in the left side of your brain, but some people use an even mix of both sides, and rarely some have right dominance for language. There is an evolutionary view that specialization of certain functions to one side or the other may be an advantage, as mainly animals, especially vertebrates, exhibit brain function with prominence on one side. Why the left side is for language isn't known, but we do know that injury or conditions such as epilepsy, if it affects the left side of the brain early in child development, can increase the chance language will develop on the right side. The chance of the person being left hand is also increased. This makes sense because the left side of the body is controlled by the motor cortex and the one right side of the brain. Selective problems. French neurologist Pierre-Paul Broca described a patient unable to speak who had no motor impairments to account for the inability. Apart from examination show a lesion in a large area towards the lower middle of the frontal lobe, particularly important in language formulation. This is now known as Broca's area. The clinical symptom of being unable to speak despite exhibiting the motor skill is known as expansive aphasia or Broca aphasia. Carl Willink observed an opposite phoneme. A patient was able to speak, but now understanding language. This now as a receptive aphasia or phrenical aphasia. The dermatic regions, as you might correctly guess, is the weakness area mentioned above. Surgeons have also observed injured patients with other selective problems, such as an inability to understand much or accept nouns, or words with unusual spelling, such as those with silent consonant, like renders difficult or talk to arise from the mac to selective areas or connection between regions in the brain's language nerve. However, phrase localization can often be difficult, given the complexity of individual symptoms and uncognate nature of their brain injury. We also know the brain's language regions work together as a coordinate work network, with some parts involved in multiple function and a level of adherence in some processing pathways, so it's not simple a matter of one brain region doing one thing in isolation. How do we know all this? Before advanced medical imaging, most of our knowledge came from observing uncomfortable patients with injuries to particular brain parts. One could relate the approximate regions of the mac to their specific symptoms. Broca's and Wilkes' observation are we known example. Other knowledge which inferred from brain stimulation studies with electrical stimulation of the brain while a patient is awake is sometimes performed in patient undergoing surgery to remove a lesion such as a tumor. The stimulation caused the part of the brain to stop working for a few seconds, which can enable the surgeon to identify areas of critical important function to avoid the mandatory surgery. In the mid century, this helped nursing function in the brain. It was clearly demonstrated that while not people have language original on the left side of the brain, some called have language organization on the right. Thank you for your attention. I'm Jasmine. Enough. I share my material. Thank you.